Hello students, in the last lecture we have seen timer instructions. In this lecture we are going to see the counter instruction and data handling instructions. So for counter, first let us see the up counter. So up counting sequence is shown here. One limit switch is there, and to that the counter is connected. Okay, and we have to set the value. And then for up counter, if it is 4, it will count for 4. That is 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So, see the format of counter instruction. It is indicated by CTU, that is for up counter. Then the counter file for PLC is C5:0. Here preset value is set to the 7, so it will count up to 7, and accumulator value is 0. It is having 2 bits, CU, that is count up bit. Whenever counter is counting, CU bit is set, and when it is finished, DN bit is set. Then there is another type of bit, that is overflow bit. So whenever the counter overflows, goes above the preset value, overflow bit is set. So here that bits are shown. C50/CU is counter enable bit. Then C50/OV, that is overflow status bit. Then C50:0/DN, counter done bit. Then C50:0, so this is reset, counter reset instruction. It is used to reset the counter. So here it is, up counter sequence. Suppose our counter is counting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 up to 7. See how the true and false conditions are indicated in the count up sequence. Then DN bit, so whenever the 7th bit is over or 7th bit is there, DN bit of counter is set. Set means true, 1. Then whenever after some time this DN bit will go low, and when reset is given. Okay, whenever reset is given. So see the accumulated values. In the accumulator, initially accumulator will be 0 as given in the instruction. Then when it will start counting 1, 3, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 up to 7, it will reach up to 7. The accumulator value will be equal to 7 until reset instruction is given. Whenever reset is given, it goes to 0 again. You can see in the diagram. So reset means whatever is the value of the counter or accumulator, reset it to 0. So here counter number, the instruction contains counter number. This number must come from the counter file. In the example shown, the counter number is C5:0, which represents counter file 5 and counter 0 in that file. The address for this counter should not be used for any other count up counter. Then preset value. The preset value can range from 2,32,768 to 1,32,767. In this example, the preset value is 7. Accumulated value. The accumulated value can also range from 2,32,768 to 1,32,767. ओके, फर्स्ट वैल्यू इंडिकेट्स व्हेन इट इज़ अप एंड डाउन काउंटर, सेकंड वैल्यू इंडिकेट्स व्हेन इट इज़ ओनली अप काउंटर और ओनली डाउन काउंटर. टिपिकली एज इन दिस एग्जाम्पल द वैल्यू एंटर्ड इन द एक्यूमुलेटेड वर्ड इज ज़ीरो. ओके, रिगार्डलेस ऑफ वॉट वैल्यू इज एंटर्ड द रिसेट इंस्ट्रक्शन विल रिसेट द एक्यूमुलेटेड वैल्यू टू ज़ीरो. So here control word of the CTU up instruction is given. It is also 16 bit word. Okay, this control word contains word 0, word 1 and word 2. Then from 00 to 09 of word 0 are not addressable, they are for internal use. Then 15th bit is for count up. If you want to use the up counter, then CU bit is set. If you want to use the down counter, CD bit is set. Whenever the counting is finished, done bit, that is DN bit, 13th number is set. Whenever counter overflows, that is goes beyond the preset value, 12th bit OV is set. And next are UN, that is 11th, and UA, that is 10th one. The word 1 is used for preset value and word 2 is used for storing the accumulated value. So here the description of these all bits is given. First is count up CU enable bit. The count up enable bit is used with the count up counter and is true whenever the count up counter instruction is true. If the count up counter instruction is false, the CU bit is false. Then done, DN bit. The done bit is true whenever the accumulated value is equal to or greater than the preset value of the counter for either the count up or count down counter. Then overflow, that is OV bit. The overflow bit is true whenever the counter counts past its maximum value, which is 32,767. On the next count, the counter will wrap around 32,768 and will continue counting from there towards zero on successive false to true transitions of the counter. Then UA bit, that is update accumulator bit. The update accumulator bit is used only in conjunction with an external high speed counter. So whenever you want to connect external high speed counter to this counter of PLC, UA bit is used. Then down counter sequence. Okay, so in the down counting, the from high value to low value counting is done. So here it is a proximity switch and down counter is used here. Okay, so see here the instruction CTD for down counting. So counter file is C5:0, preset value is 7, accumulated value is 0, and the bits attached with are CD, DN, UN, etc. Okay, C5:0/CD is counter enable bit. It is how it is represented symbolically is shown here. Then C5:0/UN is underflow status bit. So whenever it goes below the last value, under flow, that is UN bit is set. Then done bit, C5:0/DN. Then counter reset instruction is given by RES and its number is C5:0. So here it is the sequence of down counter. It is known as CTD, count down, how it occurs. Okay, so whenever the done bit is, whenever counter is counting done bit is 1, and when it stops counting, done bit goes to 0. If reset button is pressed at that time, this done bit again changes its value and actual counting. So it is this down counter with preset value 7, so it will count like 7 6 5 4 3 2 1. For the first diagram, first pulse 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 is given for the sequence, but at the last accumulated value actual counting is given. Since it is down counter, it will count like 7 6 5 4 3 2 1. So let us see more details of countdown instruction. First is counter number. This number must come from the counter file. In this example, the counter number is C5:0, which represents the counter file 5 and counter 0 in that file. The address for this counter should not be used for any other count up counter. Okay, so if you want to use the next counter, that will be C5:1, then C5:2 for the next counter, like this. But once you assign C5:0, it is used for that counter only. Then preset value. The preset value can range from 232,768 to 132,767. In this example, the preset value is 7. Accumulated value. The accumulated value can also range from 232,768 through 132,767. Typically, as in this example, the value entered in the accumulated word is 0. Regardless of what value is entered, the reset instruction will reset the accumulated value to 0. Then control word is given. Okay, so it is 16 bit word and it is having 3 words, word 0, word 1 and word 2. Sorry, from 0 to 9 it is reserved for internal use. Then for 15th bit it is count up CU, for 14th CD countdown, 13th DN, that is done, 12th overflow, that is OV, 11th UN, then 10th UA for external connections. Okay, so this word is similar to the up counter word. So if you set 15th bit CU is equal to 1, this counter will act like up counter. And if you set 14th bit, that is CD is equal to 1, this counter will act like down counter. Then word 1 is used to store the preset value and word 2 is used to store the accumulated value. So let us see various bits in this word. So now these are also similar to the previous CTD. So CTD and CTU are same. Countdown, that is CD enable bit. The countdown enable bit is used with the countdown counter, and it is true whenever the countdown counter instruction is true. If the countdown counter instruction is false, the CD bit is false. Done bit, that is DN bit. The done bit is true whenever the accumulated value is equal to or greater than the preset value of the counter for either the count up or count down counter. Underflow, that is UN bit. The underflow bit will go true when the counter counts below 32,768. The counter will wrap around to 1,32,767 and continue counting down towards zero on successive first two true rung transitions of the countdown counter. Next is update accumulator, that is UA bit. The update accumulator bit is used only in conjunction with the external high speed counter. Then data handling instructions. So up till now we have seen timer and counter instructions. Then next instruction type is data handling instruction. The mostly used data handling instructions are moved and masked move, that is MOV and MVM. So first is MOV, that is move. It moves the source value to the destination value. That is, if you want to move data from one location to another location, you have to use the move instruction. Then next is masked move, MVM. It moves data from a source location to a selected portion of the destination. So masked move is used whenever we want to move the data to a selected portion. So here is the format for the move instruction. It is used to copy data from source word to the destination word. So see here, move instruction contains source and destination. In this case, source file is N7:30 and destination file is N7:20. So whatever data is there in the N7:30 file will be moved to N7:20 file after this instruction is executed. Next, one switch is connected with this move instruction, that is the push button switch, and whenever the rung is true, that is when the input switch A is closed, this PB1 is closed, the value stored at the source address N:30 is copied into the destination address N:20. So it is shown by the blue line in the diagram. So then when the rung goes false, input switch A is opened. The destination address will retain the value unless it is changed elsewhere in the program. The source value remains unchanged and no data conversion occurs. Okay, what happens when we use the move instruction? The data from source, that is here N7:30, is copied to the destination, that is N7:20. Okay, suppose N7:30 is having value 10. So that 10 value will be moved to the N7:20. So if we don't alter, if we don't change the value at the N7:20, it will remain same. And the N7:30 will also be having the value 10. Okay, so after move instruction, the both source and destination will have the same value. Next, MVM instruction. The move with mask, that is MVM instruction, differs slightly from the move instruction because a mask word is involved in the move instruction. The data being moved must pass through the mask to get their destination address. Masking refers to the action of hiding a portion of a binary word before transferring it to the destination address. So the binary word is hide and then transferred to the destination address. So here is the format for the MVM, that is mask move instruction. So source is given first. Okay, it is stored in B3:0, suppose. Okay, and that source is having data 10101010101010101010. okay, and there is destination. Next is mask. So mask is stored at B3:1F0F, and destination is there B3:4. The pattern of characters in the mask determines which source bits will be passed through the destination address. The bits in the mask are set to 0. Do not pass the data. Okay, so if the mask contains all zeros, that means do not pass the data. It is like the secret code. Only the bits in the mask are set to 1 will pass the source data through the destination. Okay, so whenever a mask is having bits is equal to 1, it will pass the data to the destination. Bits in the destinations are not affected when the corresponding bits in the mask are 0. The MVM instruction is used to copy the desired part of 16-bit word by masking the rest of the value. Okay, so whatever part of the word or the data you want to pass, so for that mask will be 111. And whatever you don't want to pass, you have to set the bits 0 for that portion. One example is shown here. One push button switch is connected in series with the MVM instruction here. So source B3:0 will contain the data 10101010101010101010. Okay. Then mask is FFOF. In hexadecimal it is FFOF. So F is 1111. Another F is 1111, 0 is 0000, F is 1111. So means, suppose look at the source. So source, let us divide this source in the four parts having 4 bits each. Okay. So source will be having 4 parts. In the first part that there is 1010. In the second part there is 1010, like this. Okay, so from that part we don't want to pass the third part. So for that third part in the mask there is 0000. Okay, so now look at the destination B3:4 before instruction went true. So before executing the instruction, its content where, okay, destination contains 1100 1100 1100 1100. Okay, after that suppose we give the MVM instruction by pressing the push button, then this will pass the source except the third portion. So see, first portion 1010 is passed, second 1010 is passed, fourth 1010 is passed, but the third one is not passed, so it remains as it was in the destination, that is 1010. So this is how the mask is used. So in the mask where there are 00 bits, that portion is not passed. And where there are 11s, that portion is passed only. So this is how the MVM instruction is different from the MOV instruction.